And we're back. Alright. Now, I have installed a new mod. Well, it's new for this playthrough, but it's not a new mod for me. It's Chasm. C-A-S-M. Which I believe stands for Kipskis Autosave Mod. Something like that. And basically what it does is it will autosave at intervals. And it also allows me to press the F4 key and quick save. But it's a different type of quick save. So if I now go to my loading, profile 1, save 1. If I now quick save again, it'll be profile 1, save 2, so it won't overwrite the old quick save. So I can use quick save a lot, but I can also get autosave, a safer autosave. The Fallout 3 autosave is notoriously buggy, and has been the cause of crashes for some people. So, like when entering things and it autosaves and then crashes. Now, the only problem I have with the Kipskis autosave mod is that it spams you with messages when it autosaves. But apparently, you can turn that off. So let's have a look. CASM, Chasm Options Menu. Okay, so we have to close this, then we get it. Right! General settings, number of saves, current. So you can change profiles, so you can have different profiles for different characters, which is very cool. So your quick save from one character is not the same as your quick save from another. I believe you can have 3 profiles. Auto saves, save interval. The default is every 5 minutes. I'm going to leave that. I'm going to leave auto save every 5 minutes. Kind of useful. And show message. No, I don't want it saved, because that's the thing I was really bothered about for the Let's Play. I don't mind it when I'm playing myself, but for the Let's Play, I think the autosave should be hidden. You guys don't need to see that. Basically, the autosave is there in case I have a crash, so I don't have to keep worrying about quick saving all the time. Show a message when saving. Do you want Chasm to show a message when saving automatically? No. Oh, right. Okay. Will not show, so now I need back. Okay. Save while sneaking? Why wouldn't I save while sneaking? That's interesting, isn't it? Okay. I'm not sure why it would want you to not save. Auto save. Minimum health percentage. Chasm will not automatically save if your health is lower than 20%. That is probably to do with to stop you saving just before you die, which is interesting. Right, event save settings. I'm going to leave those up. I'm going to leave them. It saves under several different circumstances. Quick save settings. Show message. Let's... Do you want Chasm to show that? No. So now, hopefully, if I press the key to autosave, to quick save, I've just quick saved. I'm going to quick save again. And no message. And as you can see, save 2, save 3. Nice! Excellent. Very, very useful. Anyway, back in character. I am Will. Will, I am. Robco. Gotta find a mainframe and install a chip. That doesn't seem to be hostile. Is interesting. I wonder why that is not hostile. Okay. Oh. Ninja Mole Rat. I'm trying to use take all. If I look at them and see, I'm going to take everything, because for some reason it really annoys people. I probably mentioned that. I sort of object to. Ooh, I object to using stealth point. Nice. Using bullets on such weak creatures, but it's just too much hassle to actually. Oh, good grief. I think I'm carrying way too much. Tell you what, let's do a bit of. Nope. Can't increase those any further. Wait, yes, I'm very over-encumbered. The fission batteries are pretty heavy. These things, though, I can use those for trading with stimpaks with the outcasts, which makes them exceptionally useful. Oof. Same with the sensor modules. Oh, that is heavy. I'm dropping that. Alright, I've got some. I'm not going to take anything, even though I can sell it. I'm just completely out of space. I need to take some perks to carry more. Or get myself a backpack. That's a good point. I should install a backpack mod. I always used to, actually. Gonna do that next time. I remember a really good one that you could buy them at Moira's and you could get lots of different colours. Probably get them in black. Goes with everything. Right, yeah. Now, I've only just posted the episode before this, so I've not had time to find out if people like having the music on. So, yeah. Feel free to comment. Shall I leave the music on, or is it annoying? Or I like it. I think it's pretty atmospheric. Lots of ammo. All right. See, these things weigh a lot, but like as I said, they're worth stim packs now. I was doing you a favor, mate. I obviously put your best friend down, and you had no one to, you know, be with. It was a mercy killing. Can't believe I'm sneaking around just in case I get found by mole rats. I really should stop doing that, shouldn't I? They are only mole rats. And you watch this now, I'll get attacked by 20 mole rats and get end up having to use 15 stim packs. Told you. Well, not quite 20 stim packs, but. Oh, good grief. Stealth boys. Is there anything I don't really need? Grenade pistol. I'm keeping that. See, I don't really want the flamer at the moment. I mean, I'm terrible at these things. But I want that. EC, that is the... What's that stand for? It's the cartridges where it makes the cartridge extra cartridge, something like that. I want it. And I want these. Oh, I need the handbrake, don't I, for something else. We're four over. Tell you what, let's drop some scrap metal. I'm sort of expecting to find a repair station somewhere. You know what? I'm not risking taking random damage. I'm beginning to worry less about bullets now. Beginning to get more ammo than I really need, I think. I mean, this is, you know, the 10mm is for killing random stuff. This is the much more important. And what else have I got? Yeah, sniper rifles. It's sniper rifle ammo is what I want. Oh. Again. Right. Can I use any of these? Big Book of Science, probably not. Also, fine. Oops. I'm taking them. I'm going to go back and get myself some stimpaks for it. So I'm just going to have to drop a lot of stuff now. I think it's just time to realise I'm not going to be able to take that much scrap metal. Or what else? Gas tank for now. And I want all these. See, spoiler alert, those things are actually worth something to someone you meet later on. But Will doesn't know that. So Will should stop picking them up. This is what we're looking for. Alright, so what I can do now is too heavy. What's that? Robco jumpsuit. Tempting. Now I get near to this, I get higher skills, so I can now maybe if I change to my jumpsuit, can I fix it? Yes, a little bit. Oh, I should not do that. What I should do is make repair kits. Now, what was it that I was thinking? Ammo press. The ammo press. What do I need? One iron, steam... Oh, you know what? Pilot lights. Do you think I can find that sort of stuff here? What was that again? Ammo press. One iron, steam gauge assembly, motorcycle handbrake, got... Scrap got... It's doing that itself. Two pilot lights. I think I've got everything I need back at home, but, you know, it'd be nice to get it here as well. Right. Repair parts. Alright, I've got no scrap metal now. But hopefully... Right, still encumbrance. Yeah, the repair parts will repair a little better than the scrap, I believe. Alright, and still overweight though. Still overweight. Steam gauge assembly. Scrap metal, I know I dropped loads in there, so the thing I would be needing is pilot lights. Which I'm not going to find. I think, not here anyway. What am I thinking? Broken items cannot be equipped. Right, I've healed it a little bit. Now I can equip it. This is what I needed to do. Went mod. Remove. Extended clip. That's it. Extended clip. Not enhanced. Crafting. Yes! Right, so I get that wet mod and then I can drop the flamer. Because this thing's heavy. Oh, that's better. That is better. And let's just make sure I'm wearing everything. Right, so if I find... There's scrap metal everywhere. There's steam gauge assembly right there. If I find pilot lights, I'm coming back. Right! They just make such an irritating noise. Nice. Oh no, we don't want to go down again. In there. Night vision again. I didn't actually mean to go into bullet time there, but I've got bullet time set for the same key as melee on Borderlands 2 and Left 4 Dead. So I turned around and tried to melee him. Oh dear. Actually, maybe I'll get a pilot light. Kitchen. Pilot lights. pile of light. Yes! One. Two. Right. Sugar bombs. You never know. I'll do it on the way out. Okay. Yeah, that scared me a teeny bit. As did that. I love the way bullets decapitate people. Like, not even people. Great big mutant mole rats. I probably should reduce the gore back to normal levels. I did it because, as people were pointing out, to stop ghouls from resurrecting, you shoot them in the head till their heads explode. But because I had realistic gore settings, that was not happening. So I put it up to medium gore, which is unfortunate because it does look a little silly. You know what? Turning the night vision off and turning the light on instead. It's just a little easier to see. It's a little creepy, that, isn't it? I think we're safe listening to that music. By safe, I mean I don't think there's any copyright issues. Definitely picking up a lot of energy cells. Been here, haven't I? This is where I came in, yes. Factory floor. So. So what was this way then? More energy cells. Nice. Well, it's not that bad actually, tribal healing powder. It's not terrible. 45. Already? Alright, what if I've taken too much of, do you think? Probably Nuka-Cola. Oh, let's drop those. I know I can sell them, but they weigh something. I'd rather have ammo. Speak of the devil. Sniper rifle bullets. Now that's a book I can use, I believe. Yes, and now if I look at the miscellaneous, I think... Or is it under aid? I see it's supposed to be, I see it somewhere as red, and then I can drop it. Yeah, never mind. Probably being a bit of a doofus. It's probably staring me in the face. Whoa, have I been that way? Completely lost. Factory floor is where I came from. I need to be going this direction. I think up, actually. Yep, been from there. The music's a little creepy. Actually, more than a little. Okay, that looks like a mainframe. Let's check around and... Locked. What do we have in here? Lock duct off. I think we can drop some surgical supplies and hope I don't get that injured. Did know. Like mine. Oh! Oh. See, now I absolutely have to know what's in there. A bottle cap mine and then run, because those things are seriously, seriously tough. Oh dear. Now, I just had a crash when trying to breach that lock. Luckily, I only lost a couple of minutes because I have Chasm. But when I reloaded and then attempted to re-breach this, I had another crash. Which is interesting. Maybe breach locks is a little buggy for me? That's interesting. Anyway, probably just... One of the things I have done is I have, oh, is that it? 8 bottle caps. I used a bottle cap mine and 2 frag mines to get in there. Alright. Yeah. Nice. Junk metal hammer. Yeah, my graphics card, which is a 580, has been making a funny noise on the fan. But it only occurs when the fan drops below 45%. So I installed MSI Afterburner and set it so that it always stays above 45, but I'm wondering whether I've got my profile a little bit. Oh, good grief. Again? I'm wondering if the profile for it needs to be adjusted a bit. Maybe I got some overheating, which is possible. I need something to drop. I can't believe I dropped the flamer and I'm still... Oh, it's the missile launch, isn't it? Well, I'm not dropping that, that's for sure. What do I need? I only need one. I'll tell you what. That should be enough. Okay, that's weightless. That's too heavy. Blood pack, too heavy. Alright, so... locked average. Oh, you're kidding me. Okay, I just had another crash right as I got here. And basically, I'm not totally sure what it is, but it is kind of weird because when I came back, I found there was a save right here as I clicked on this. So either it auto-saved just before a crash through sheer luck, or maybe the new auto-save mod is causing me crashes. However, one of the other things I noticed was my graphics card was stupidly hot. So I think the MSI Afterburner, sorry, has... I think the profile I set for the fan is not correct. And whilst it was nice and quiet, was just not working correctly. So, or, and this is the other one, MSI Afterburner and Fallout 3 don't like each other. And that's a possibility. Option number, I don't know where I'm up to, but the other option is, of course, MSI Afterburner does things like screenshots and even captures video. And I'm wondering if it's interfering with DxTorry, the program I use for recording. So that could be another thing. So I've deactivated that, and maybe that will stop me crashing. Well, we'll find out, won't we? Hack? Can I hack the computer? I didn't think so. Install the processor widget. No, it's locked. Oh. Oh, I forgot about that. Oh, I'm overweight again. Alright. Attack on hostile. Oh! Where were the... He's gonna explode. Will not be tolerated. Oh, there's loads of them. All these things I've been looting. You know, I thought of a good way of reducing my weight. Grenade! Hey, look! Hey, look at that! Kill people and reduce wait. So I'm carrying a bit less now as well because of the fishing back. Oh, I'm overweight now. Oh, you know what? Conductors. I was thinking about this. They're heavy. I use them to repair, but I'm not sure I can swap them with the outcasts for things. I don't think that's one of the things I can use. I think it is sensor modules, fission batteries. I'm gonna drop some of those. So where am I going? Where am I going? Data. Over there. Okay. I don't hear anyone. Sounds like we're alone at last. Peace and quiet. I checked that already, didn't I? Did I? What's that? Oh. The turret that wasn't hostile. Was that there's usually come in pairs. Was there any others? Alright. We are no longer alone.
Hostile. Target identified.
Why am I sneaking? I'm... Oh, I've got my light on. Sneaking with a light on. Even more useful. Oh, and I tell you what I want to do while I'm in here. I want to find a... I want to find a... repair bench. The repair bench. I'm going to take some scrap metal just to make sure I've got enough. I want to make my ammo press. Where it was. Was it down? It was probably down. So what are they fighting? I thought I killed everything. Did I leave some bugs behind? There we go. Alright, well, you know what? Steam gauge assembly. Alright, ammo! I'd like to make an ammo press kit. You need at least an... Oh, iron! I don't have an iron. I never found an iron. Oh. Ah, that was what I was missing. An iron. Yeah, you know what? So, what don't I need then? I've got pilot lights at home. After all that, I've got steam gauge assembly. Right. Oh, no. Just when I think, got them all. I can hear those voices. Oh! Really? Really? Tell you what. A tribal thingy powder.
Put down your weapons and submit to authority.
Yeah. That's not gonna happen, mate. I am not putting down my weapon. I ain't submitting to a damned thing. Now I think we've got them. Maybe not. Seriously? Anyone else? Oh! Alright, let's have a conductor or two. Everyone else dead? Doesn't look hostile. Sergeant RL3. Tinker Joe.
Hello, stranger. I'm Tinker Joe. Premier supplier of robotic parts and service throughout the DC wasteland.
All right. You should... Yeah, give me a robot.
I'm afraid these bots are all spoken for. I'm just delivering them now.
Oh.
I've got a custom Gutsy that isn't spoken for, but... Well, RL3's a bit finicky about the company he keeps. And
what?
I don't think he likes the look of you.
What?
Nothing personal, of course.
I look awesome. All right, what do I have to do to get him?
Various things.
Let's see what you got. Nothing. And no caps either. Alright. Well, Mr. Handy.
Another glorious day in this man's army.
I have got to find out what I gotta do to get you as a follower. However, we did it! Robco! Completed. Now I'm going to go back to the outcasts and claim some stimpaks and then get back to Moira. And then I think I'm going to head on into the DC wasteland, you know. I'm beginning to think I'd like to pay a visit to GNR Radio.
I don't want to set the world on fire.